Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
New Orleans, Louisiana, home of the famous French Quarter, the site for our football contest today.
Tulane is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. And he'll return this one from the 7. He's out to the 30. Gets out to about the 31. The Hilltoppers have a new head man. New theories, new hopes, new dreams. Will there be new wins? We'll find out. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. This one out to the right. What a pick! Out of bounds
at about the 47-yard line.
Not only did he demonstrate his leaping ability, but he also has the hands to be able to pull the ball in. Great job.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47. He's going to try and scramble. There he goes. And they make the stop at the 31.
A good quarterback knows when and how to improvise. And if he's got the skills, he can also turn a scramble into something big.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 31. He's tackled
at about the 33-yard line.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
Makes the catch and look out. And he's tackled around the 24-yard line.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
From the 24-yard line, it's third down. Fires quickly to the tight end, and he tackles him hard at the 19. Makes the catch for about 5 yards on the play, and that's good for a first down.
I'll tell you, these guys just keep rolling down the field. Quarterback's looking very sharp on this drive.
They'll bring him down at the 17.
Gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 17. They get nice yardage on that run.
That'll bring up third and 2.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. On the run. They go to the left for a nice game. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. He's scrambling. Keeps it, and he's got a touchdown. Run there by that quarterback.
Well, great decision by the quarterback reading the defense, and as soon as he saw the open field, he cut it upfield and scored the touchdown.
And he converts the extra point. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
The Demon Deacons came into the game ranked 9th. after the bitterly disappointing loss, how far will the Bolters move them down? How about this final? Totally unexpected, a major upset is now finished. The Broncos win it by 19.
Wow, what an upset. I'm not sure anybody would have predicted that one. Tulane is lining up to kick this one off. Gathered in at the 6. He makes it out to maybe the 29-yard line. Tulane's really got things working right now for him. I can't think of a better start.
Well, that's exactly the way they had hoped to see this game go. I mean, anytime you can start the game with a stop, get your offense out there, they move the ball down, put points on the board. Now it's just more about trying to maintain what they've already created.
An interception cut this offense last drive short, so I think they're going to be looking for a little more success right here.
He's got a lot of time to forget about that last pick. He's just got to stick to the game plan.
The Hilltoppers are looking for some new players to step up this season, Herbie. And, you know, every team needs a new star to be born year in and year out because you lose a fifth of your roster to graduation every year. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Bird gets another carry. Nice run to the outside. So we got a few yards on that carry.
If you can continue to pick up small chunks of yards like that, you can really start to wear a defense down.
Fires out to his wideout. Tackle made around the 48-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Throws incomplete, intended for his wideouts.
I love to see a confident quarterback, but you don't want to just go back there and put blind faith into your throws. You need a little bit more time to evaluate the coverage before you release the football.
Again, he'll get the call. He fights forward to about the 49.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. First down.
From the 49-yard line, it's first down. 5 wide. And down he goes at about the 41.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
He's at the 30. Gains his way to the 20-yard line.
First down.
And this is the 8th play of the drive. Makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 20-yard line. Brought down at the 12-yard line.
Gain of 8 yards. That makes it third and 3.
Hang on, everybody, because it looks like they came ready to play today. 7-0, Greenway. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. He's going to come up short. Good tackle. Pick up of a yard for the tailback. This should be an easy field goal. He gets it up, and they tack on 3 points.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He Hayes to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 25.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Tulane holds a 4-point. Here's the halfback. And he's level at the 35. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35. Fires incomplete.
The ball just sailed on him and he knows it. He'll get it next time.
Taken down at the 36.
Call it a gain of 1 yard. That'll make it 39.
From their own 36-yard line, third down. Finds his man, and they take him down immediately.
There's a flag down, and this most likely is going to be on the defense.
Offense.
West picks him up 6 yards with a catch.
Call it a gain of 6 yards. That brings up fourth and three.
Matthews awaits the snap. They bring him down, and they bring him down hard on that one.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Run play and he'll lose yards.
Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
From their own 30-yard line, second down. Defensive coordinator anticipating this five-wide set, and he comes in with his dime package. And it's almost picked off.
Man, I don't know if this quarterback misread the defense or just made a poor decision, but that wasn't a pass he should have thrown.
Man left, man left. Go down.
He chucks it downfield, caught with room to work. He's taken down around the 19-yard line.
You can chalk that one up to the hundreds of passes the quarterback has thrown to this receiver in practice. These guys know and trust each other, and you could see it in the way he threw that pass.
Now it's first and 10 with the defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Tackle at the 5.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route. Good protection and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Throws to the receiver, and he's got it again.
This entire group functions so well as a unit, and you saw it on that touchdown. Very good team effort.
Trying to go up by 3, they'll kick the extra point. He makes the PAT. A 5-play, 67-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, how about the guys up front? The offensive line giving the quarterback plenty of time to be able to read the defense and make the right throw.
The score now, 10-7. They line up to kick this one away. He'll return it from the 3. In a
game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions.
Now he tries to buy some time. Tries to get around the corner. He keeps it. He's knocked out of bounds at the 47.
First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line.
He's on the run. He scrambled and picked up a couple of yards.
He really did a nice job of anticipating the run and making the play on the ball carrier. That's the right way to catch a pass.
From the 36-yard line, first down.
He scrambled. That's a great tackle at the 30.
Good coverage by the defense, but they have to be aware of this quarterback's tendency to scramble around and pick up some yards.
Tulane's going to use their first time out of the half here.
Now he's scrambling. Now he shows his running ability. He's at the 20, and he hits him hard at the 10-yard line.
Tulane's going to have to use their second time out of the half. From the 10-yard line. First down. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That brings him second and five.
To his receiver, touchdown.
A good football team has to consistently be able to capitalize when they're in the red zone.
Tacks on the extra point. Tulane lines up for the kickoff. Chance takes it at the 8. And down he goes at the 25-yard line.
The Hilltoppers are struggling trying to get their star wide receiver in this game, and sometimes, you know, Herbie, it's almost like a jump shooter in basketball. Get him to the free throw line, get him one free one from 15 feet and see how he can do. They got to get the ball in his hand somehow.
I agree with you 100%. I mean, it's just a matter of just one play, one touch to get this guy going, because he has that kind of ability. And up to this point, they've not been able to find the way to get him the ball. Give credit, a lot of credit to this defense for coming in with a good plan. But now it's up to the offense to make their own adjustments to kind of counter that attack by this defense to be able to get the ball into the hands of their go-to guy.
They'll spread the field with five wide.
And he's shoved out of bounds at the 46-yard line.
This guy has that innate ability to get just enough distance from a defender to make a completion possible. You don't see it from every receiver, but this guy's got it.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 46-yard line.
He fires. And it's incomplete. So the referee is going to take a look at several angles. Now remember, he's seeing the same thing we are, and he needs indisputable video evidence to overturn the call. So the official's taking a look at this play to see if the receiver got a foot in bounds.
Regardless of the outcome of this review, I still think that this guy made an excellent catch.
So they'll overturn the call and rule this a completion.
There was a bad call made on the field, but they were able to fix it because of the replay. This is exactly why the booth review is a great thing for college football.
Slings it. And they make the stop.
Right around the 6-yard line.
Western Kentucky will have one timeout remaining. It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, Hilltopper. Bird's had high expectations since he was a high schooler, and now it looks like he's every bit as good as suggested. Congratulations to him on his first touchdown. So the kicker will line up here and try to give his team a 3-point lead with this extra point. And he hits the PAT. Bates is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the one. He gets out to about the 25-yard line.
Boy, this is turning into a shootout here. Now, remember, the last time we saw this offense out in the field, they answered the bell and scored a touchdown. Can they do that now a second time? I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. And I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
Halfback's got it on the quick throw. He's tackled at the 44.
You obviously have to worry about him as a ball carrier, but he showed here that you have to be concerned about him as a receiver as well. He's got good hands, and you know he's good in the open field.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. Throws it deep. Missed him. Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 17-14, Western Kentucky. Very close game now as we start the second half. Gathered in at the 6. He's out to the 30. Tackle made at the 32.
Right, this has been a great game to watch. A lot of competitive spirit out there. The offenses seem to be going up and down the field. Back and forth we go. I think the winner will be which defense can make that pivotal stop to secure a victory.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Here's an opening. Tackle made right around the 48-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. And he's tackled around the 49-yard line.
That'll make it second and 7.
Pass. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 31. first and 10. Ball on the 31. Runs outside for a nice gain. Down 10 yards to go. Ball on the 10. Nice run, and he's brought down.
That's a D4. That makes it second and six.
The eighth play of the series. They come out in a goal line set. Hand off to the left. Touchdown, Tulane!
It shouldn't have surprised these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it. And the good news for this offense is they took the lead back. But the bad news is that the other offense is more than capable of putting points up on the board as well.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Wait till you see what's happened in Austin. And for Texas, we've got a little drama starting to unfold right now. A potential major upset in the making. The Ohio State leads it 7-3.
People were predicting some upsets this week, but I'd be shocked if that score holds up. Matthew has the ball set, and he looks ready to kick this one deep. Chance has it at the 5. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Got it, but he's going to lose yards here. So it's 2nd and 12. Ball on their own 21. And he carries the ball for a nice gain.
That'll bring up 3rd and 8.
Taken down at the 40-yard line.
First down.
From their own 40-yard line, it's first down. Five guys will be out in the pattern as they're in the shotgun. They'll line it up again on third down. And it's caught, and he's brought down quickly.
is fourth and four.
Miles back deep to return. Brought down at the 18-yard line. They ran the ball very well on their last drive, and it resulted in six. Tulane holds a four-point lead. Scrambling around. Brought down at the 28.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
First and 10, ball on the 28-yard line. He's taken down at the 30-yard line.
West, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and eight.
Completely stopped immediately. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. So at the end of the third quarter, the green wave in front, 21-17. Welcome back to the action. Fourth quarter. This one will decide it. Tight ball game through three.
Green nine.
Tackle at the 43-yard line.
You talk about a dual threat guy. This guy can hurt you in the air or on the ground.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 43. Makes it out to maybe the 46-yard line.
That's good for 83 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Tulane is up by four.
There aren't too many quarterbacks in the country who can make that throw. And the ones that can are playing on Sunday.
So the big gain resulting from the pass play leaves us with a first and 10. Field tackle.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker's blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Let's see if they try to pound it in here. Both teams have their goal line sets on the field. Touchdown, Green Wave.
Oh, that's a great job of some tough running right there. When you get close to the end zone, things get very tight, and it's tough to maneuver.
He makes the PAT. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
We head for the Austin City Lemons. This one's been entertaining us all day long. And for Texas, they're struggling to take control of this game. McGill flashed the sticky fingers as he's hauled in a touchdown. The Buckeyes have the lead, 21-20, early in the third quarter.
I don't expect that score is going to hold, but boy, that would be an upset. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Chance fields it at the 7. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. So we're just about ready to return to action.
All right, D, let's, all
it to the 34.
That's going to be a gain of 8 yards. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Bird on the run. And they push him out
around the 38-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. First down.
Quick throw, incomplete. Waddle's receiver. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws, he's improved. But as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
Throws it out, and it falls incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
From their own 38-yard line, third down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. He's under pressure. He's going to go for the home run. The ball is loose, and they make the stop at the 30.
It's careless mistakes like this that can completely turn a game around. He's simply got to be more careful with the football.
So the booth and the referee agree. The runner's knee was down.
That was still a close call, though, Brad. Even though he was down, this guy has to do a better job of holding that football.
He scrambled. Big play, and it's first and goal. Two-score game, and they can cut that down here if they can get this one in the end zone. Just under three to go in regulation. He's tackled at the 4-yard line. The defender wanted a head start, and they certainly got him for it.
Defense. Automatic first down.
Gets rid of it. It's second and goal. Ball on the 5-yard line. Fires over the middle. Touchdown. Receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And the quarterback stays on the field as they try for the 2-point conversion. And they won't get the two. A 7-play, 37-yard drive. But the failed 2-point conversion keeps it a 6-point score. Bates is lined up to kick this one off. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line. The finish line's in sight. Let's see who wants this one more.
You know, we still have a lot of time left in this game. It's not as if the offense can just take a knee 3 times and get out of here with a win. I still think they've got to be aggressive. At the same time, the quarterback's got to make good decisions, make sure that he and the running back secure that football, and they cannot afford to turn it over.
And he is drilled at the 42. First and 10. Ball on their own 42.
Just over 2 minutes in the game.
Going to try and scramble. That's a great tackle at the 47.
Brad, that's a huge first down for this offense. At this point, the defense's only hope is they've got to try to rip that ball away from the quarterback or the running back to get the football back to their offense, because the clock now is a big factor.
Western Kentucky will take their second time out of the half. Pitts gets 7 yards on the play. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Well, the execution of this offense has been on display here on this drive. They know what they needed to do, and that's pick up the first down, work the clock, and finish this game off. And with that first down, they may have done it.
Nice run there. Pitts gains about 5 yards on the run. It's second down, 5 to go. Ball on the 31-yard line.
Red 2, X 7.
Nice run there as they work the outside. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. Favorite play in football of your quarterback, take a knee. So that's going to do it. Our final score in this one, 28-23, Tulane.
And the Hilltoppers.
So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.